you talk a lot about, to find value in things that are completely underperforming or actually underutilized. So can you
Yes.
talk about that? Because I think it's a fabulous point that is across every company.
Well, Jesus, I mean, I'll take it internal, external. So every company has some way, they got a revenue generating system. So first thing is we have something called revenue system optimization. We look at the revenue system and we question every facet. Are you targeting the right category of market, the most qualitative, the most responsive? How are you targeting it? Where are you targeting? What's the message you're targeting? What's the offer or the way you're trying to evoke a connection? What are you doing when you have that connection? What are you doing, to convert that connection to monetization? What do you do afterwards? How do you do it? How many other ways could you do it? Then inside you say, okay, what other things does your buyer buy, before, during, after? How can you sell that to them? Who else sells that? Could the people that sell other things be your partner? Could you buy those kind of businesses to complement it since you're selling to it? Then you say, okay, if I have a lot of salespeople or a lot of distributors or a lot of franchisors, franchisees, there's variation. Different people are performing at different levels, and most people don't break it down. If you have 10, 20, 100 salespeople, they're not all going to be the same. Some are going to be stronger in one thing, weaker in others. Some are better at opening accounts. Some are better at selling different products. Some are better at holding margins. Some are better at selling multiple products. Some are better in conservation. Some are better at selling to different industries. You need to figure out who's better at what and why and how much better, and figure out how to get either them to teach everybody else what they know that others don't, or if they're many times better, how to be a specialist and only do that one thing and pass them to other people. If you have unsold prospects, you need to figure what else you can go back and monetize them. If you have inactive buyers, you got to figure out how to monetize those. If you see within the core of your business an accidental significant category of people that seem attracted to you, doctors, bicyclists, triathletes, anything, then you want to go after that because you unintentionally are appealing to them. If you have methodology, processes, techniques, systems, procedures that outperform your competitors, but you're only operating in a limited geography or market, and it could be used by lots of other people, you want to be able to identify what they are, quantify it, and then sell, lease, profit share, train people, license people to do that. You want to basically see how many other ways you can penetrate different niches of the market. You want to see if you got control of competitive businesses and consolidating them with economies of scale and eliminating duplicated functions and brought them all into one location. If you can make a lot more profit, you want to see if you can buy them without putting any money up front and letting them buy themselves. You mean it's all kind. I can go on and on and on and on and on.
I love your answers, Jay. Oh man. So is there like a way that a company can start to document or to create like a list of their resources or their assets so they can start actually kind of predictably but thinking about this, right? Instead of just saying, hey, of course, what do I have? I've got all this thing like
Yeah, we had years ago, I don't know if I still have it, an asset, an intangible and tangible asset, sort of a inventory list. And we have a 200 question assessment that makes you look within your business. And I wouldn't mind giving it to you to give away to people. I don't know if I can find the inventory because I don't do a lot of this anymore. But yeah, I mean, the answer to everything is yes. But also the answer to your question is they must, because if why would you be? Here's a really interesting question, Alex. Why in the world would you want to be in business and dedicate your career or your life or all your investable capital or your income expectation or your wealth and security expectation or your retirement expectation or your lifestyles, support? Or your sense of purpose and fulfillment to something that was going to vastly underperform its capacity. It makes no sense, does it?
No, it doesn't make sense. But I think a lot of company people who start companies, they get to a point where it just becomes so busy within it that they kind of lose their passion.
They don't have their joy anymore,
which you talk about.
Yeah, I agree. I absolutely agree. And honestly, it's tragic. Because there are very, very few companies, large, small, doesn't matter the type, size, scope, that couldn't really perform at a such heightened level of everything, impact, profitability, contribution, but they don't know it's possible. And really, I'm an anomaly. There are very few people like me, and you found me in the 70s. I'm very mentally agile, and I hope my prowess is significant, but I'm a very unique anomaly. Almost nobody you'll ever meet would be able to freely discuss this and be able to realistically, empirically relate to this from real life experiences. You've got a lot of theoretical people teaching one trick pony tactics. You got people that have been exposed to someone like me trying to utter their interpretation. But what I stand for is I'm on almost a mission myself to try to force people while I'm still on this earth to really do a lot more with any business they have, any practice professionally, any startup, any businesses they invest in, because why would you want to do less?